Goodbye, goodbye to all the fake people in my life. I never wanted you around me, so be on your way now. You better think twice. Yo, what's going on? You're tuning in to another exciting Mario Ramon review. And today we are going to review our girls of Potomac, the Real Housewives of Potomac. This one is, what is the name of this one? This one is called 50 Shades of Betrayal. And it's just like, you know, the reason I play fake people is because everybody, it just appears that they're so fake in this. You know, Ashley is trying to be friends with Candace until Monique needs her. And now she's going to give her a little defamation of character letter. And then Karen, she said she's not going to invite Monique to her wig party. And then she invites her to her wig party. And so we have a case of the fake people. So let's just jam to this, okay? Let's give homage to the fake people. Hey, before we get into the video, definitely, if you like the video, subscribe to the channel. Like the video and comment. Okay, let's have some fun. Everybody's on lockdown and COVID, and we still have to have fun, okay? So you found the right channel if you want to have some fun. Okay, let's do this in decency and order. This is season 5, episode 17. We're going to give it to you the way you like it. If you love the Real Housewives of Potomac, then this is your video. You don't want to miss a word that is coming out of my mouth, okay? Let's get straight into it. They are out abroad, as we said last week, and you know, Giselle, she is just not going to let me down. And we're not going to even start on Giselle's wardrobe right now. We already did the ponytail. So we're not going to beat a dead horse. Like, that was the ponytail that I Dream of Jeannie wore for all of her seasons. And then when she took it off, I don't know, Giselle must have bought it in an auction. And she said, I'm going to wear this I Dream of Jeannie ponytail. I don't come hell or high water. Now, Giselle knows she should have had her hair done before she went out of the country. You should have had your hair done 48 hours before. I am not buying what you're selling. Giselle almost gives me a little manly because, I'm not trying to hurt nobody's feelings. Let me just make this disclaimer and I just got to say what I got to say. Giselle is giving me manly because the rest of the ladies, we had Candace looking really good. We had Wendy looking really good. And we had Karen looking really good. And y'all calling Karen mummy pussy because y'all are trying to act like Karen is just, you know what I'm saying, older than Chinese currency. And that's not fair. And she looks, Karen was looking better than everybody. She came out with these goddamn outfits. I don't know if she went into a phone booth and turned around 3 times and turned into Wonder Woman or whatever. But Karen was coming out with these outfits, especially that Chanel outfit that she told, which when she put the phone up under her dress and let Ray see her E-I-E-I-O. That outfit was giving it to me the way I like it. And then she came out with that red outfit. She was like, look, bitch, I might be older than Chinese currency, but I'm going to give y'all these motherfucking old ass outfits, honey. I'm going to give you these outfits. So what I was saying about, back to you, Giselle, what I was just saying about her giving manly energy, her and Robin, because Robin is a chromosome away from an 18-wheeler truck driver that resides in Tennessee. Go all up in the gas station with no shoes on, all that shit. Baby ain't got no shoes on, baby on the hip with no shoes on, feet dirty. A chromosome away. And Robin is too pretty to be playing with me like this. She is stunning. But she will not comb her hair. She will not comb her hair. You can put the comb in her hair at hand, but you cannot make her comb it. She will not do it. You'd be like this. She'd be like, no, stop. Stop. I'm not combing my hair. Stop. Now, I'm not combing my hair. If you're my friend, you're going to love me if I comb my hair or not. Robin, comb your hair. I'm going to pinch and twist it. See, you need me as your friend. Don't get mad at me. Don't turn the video off. Listen to what I'm saying. Listen to what I'm saying. I'm not trying to hurt you. I'm not being mean. Comb your damn hair. It always looked like you didn't put a cup of water upside down on your hair and go to the event. I'm going to fuck you up. Allegedly. Okay. And so, like I said, Giselle's sitting all on her foot in the hotel lobby where her shoe is on the ground backwards. So her it looked like an Adidas sandal for men. It really looked like an Adidas sandal, one of them old school Adidas sandal for men. So Giselle had her shoe on the ground. It was backward, and she was sitting on her leg like this. And the other ladies were sitting down like they were auditioning to be the fourth member in Vogue. And here go Giselle, just honking on. I was waiting on her to pull out like a rib sandwich and stuff and eat it right there, honey, and wipe her hands on her dress or on the furniture. I'm waiting for that to happen one day. I really believe that that's going to happen one day with Giselle and Robin, the Shady twins. And Giselle, she's such a classic beauty. I mean, she is one of those pretty beauties that's like Vanessa Williams. You know what I'm saying? She's a classic. She's a classic beauty. But basically, it's like having a dirty Bentley with a dummy tire on it. Like, it's a Bentley, but it's dirty and it has a dummy tire on it. I'm over it. Ashley came down looking like a housekeeper. Don't be saying nothing to me. Talking about she just had, I don't care. She been giving us outfits thus far. It's just, this time. She was giving me a housekeeper wear. Robin came out with a Stevie Wonder collection. He was like, I think this looks good. You should put this on. The stripes and the roses was just giving me neck twist. What's neck twist, Uncle Mario? Neck twist. That outfit with the hair, with the cup of water, it was just... it's just too much for me. I'm gonna have to stop watching the show. I'm just gonna have to stop watching the damn show. I am. Oh my God. What else? Oh, I thought Giselle had redeemed herself when she had on that fake Versace sarong thing on and then the yellow bathing suit until I saw the tan marble buttons going down that bathing suit. I almost passed out, literally. It's just becoming too much for my pressure. You know, I'm not gonna be able to eat the foods that I wanna eat for Thanksgiving because you have to count your stress and you can't fight every battle. So I'm not gonna be able to watch The Housewives of Potomac and eat what I wanna eat for Thanksgiving. My pressure's gonna go fucking sky high. Fucking with y'all. Now I'm not going to be able to eat what I want to eat for Thanksgiving. Fucking with your outfits. Oh, that's wearing me out. Monique. They could film Monique going to the bakery. They could film Monique going to the grocery store. I'm pretty sure she's involved with PTA, taking the kids to soccer with a little face mask on. Don't do this to her. Where is Monique? It's not fair to the audience. It's not fair to us that we can't get to see Monique. This shit ain't fair because Candace running around here being dramatic and shit with these sticky notes. You're gonna be okay. Then bitch, if you got to walk around with sticky notes all over your whole house like that, then you need some other kind of attention. I thought your mother can give you the kind of attention, but does she not treat family members? Should ask her to give you a recommendation. Honey, you push 12 on an elevator and it's stuck at 4. Figure it out. I'm tired of this. Candace's body was banging and she was dancing and all that, but it's kind of like R. Kelly in the music. I can't get past the things that you're doing to have fun with you, Candace. It's hard to get past the things that you've done and that you're doing to Monique. But she attacked me. I get it. But you're making it way crazier than it really needs to be. Because what if someone did that to you and your ass could have been facing jail when you had the knife? Kathleen Bates in Misery. Your crazy ass. But you like, no. I'm not working for this money. She's gonna give it to me. Like my mama gave me money. I ain't working for no money. Y'all giving me this money, honey. Okay? Go ahead and sit down on it, Candace. oh, that motorcycle ride, when they all walked out, let's talk about Ashley's pants, or let's not. I don't want to be mean to Ashley no more, because she got a lot going on, but them pants were not right with the Lord, Ashley. If you wear something like that again, I'm going to light you up. I'm lighting it up. I'm setting it off. I'm setting it off. I'm going to light it up, honey. You wear them pants again. I'm going to let you slide this time. Candace, that shirt she had with them sleeves, and it looked like she killed a couple of teddy bears. This heifer done killed some teddy bears and made a shirt. I feel a neck twist coming on. Oh my goodness, please leave my neck alone. It can't take too much more. I'm gonna be sitting there eating some bland ass. I think I might just go to the fucking hospital cafeteria on Thanksgiving and eat some bland food. Cause I know I'm not gonna be able to eat shit. I wanna eat messing with this TV show. Cause my pressure be going up and I know I ain't gonna be able to eat no hot sauce. I can't. When Robin came out with that Fonz outfit, remember Happy Days? Hey, she came out with that Robin looked like a stunt woman for the Terminator. Remember the Terminator when he had that Sarah Connor jacket on? Robin had the same jacket on. I am waiting for Robin to literally one day just grab her crouch and be like, what's up, y'all? Y'all ready to go? Y'all ready to go? I'm like, is she? She's giving me everything I need. Shit. She's giving me everything I need. Or not. I'm just saying, that damn Fonz outfit, I just couldn't take it. The sexy outfits, when they all came sexy, here go. Okay, so let's just talk about all the sexy. I like Karen, was age appropriate. She said, you'll never get $100 million out of me, honey. She was like, I'd like to see the receipts. Karen Kane, very age appropriate, and she wore a little fur, you know, a little shallah. And then Robin tried to comfort her and say, you look like Cruella DeVille. And honey, Karen came out of her mind. It was like Venus and Serena. You hit that ball at me, bitch. I'm hitting it right back at you. She said, you look like Cruella DeVille. And she said, and you look like a whore on the streets. Karen put her glasses at the tip of her nose and she be reading like a librarian technician. Do you hear me? She reads with her glasses at the tip of her nose. And you know you reading. If you push it, you push the paper away from you, bitch, with your glasses on. You are reading, honey. Read with the paper pushed away. Honey, Karen be making you clutch your imaginary gay pearls, because when Karen took that hat and her confessional and threw it on the ground, I almost blacked out. Who's going to pay my doctor bill one day if I'm just so happen to walk into the kitchen to go get some water while I'm watching this TV show and they do this shit to me and I hit my head on this hardwood? Who should I mail my bill to? Bravo? Andy? Karen, who? Because I wasn't doing shit. I just had my television on. This is so sad. Karen got Robin's ass because Robin didn't put her. And see, the way Robin announced her website was just shady. And I cannot appreciate it. And I'm not going to support it the first year. Let's just say that. Because I would have bought my mom and all my aunties and everybody. But no. It was shady. She gonna go in front of Karen and say, oh, my website is up and running. And then didn't even have a conversation, didn't have the decency. Like I said, Karen got out of her fucking coffin to come to this photo shoot for you. And you didn't even have the decency to tell her you're not even in the photo shoot. You're gonna find out about it when we find out about it on the air and when all the girls find. Shady, shady. If you were on fire, I wouldn't piss in a cup and throw it on you. I have better things to do with my piss, honey. Throw it on the ground, honey. Fertilize the ants. Nope. That was wrong. That was wrong. And I'm glad Karen threw that damn hat on the ground. It was an ugly hat anyway. Karen was cuter than the hat was. Now, that's for damn sure. And that's probably why you didn't want the photo shoot. Because the hat was ugly, honey. You should have gave her something to work with, Pumpkin Lamb. And maybe she would have turned the photo shoot out. You know, when you give people garments to put on, they feel good and they transform. Maybe she didn't feel good in your garment. Now that's the read. That is not even a read, bitch. That's Braille, honey. Right. Put your finger on it. Press. Honey, I ain't got time for half this shit you talking about, Robin. That was just so mean girlish. Hold on. I'm just looking at everything. Okay, so listen. Karen keeps trying to act like she's so baffled why Ray treats her like shit. It's because you treat him like shit. You just said on national television, you don't like his penis. And then they resurfaced, they regurgitated it last week. And now this week, you're talking about how you retire giving him oral. First of all, that's your bedroom and you are 450 years old. You already know not to put the family laundry out. Like that. It's some things you just, we didn't have to know that. We didn't have to know that. It's just a double-edged sword. Because what if Ray got on a TV show and was like, said some, mortifying things to you? You got mad when he said, all he said is, I don't know that I'm in love with you anymore. Because you said you don't love my penis on national TV. And you said that you don't like giving me oral sex on national TV. So I don't know if I like your funky ass. And that's how I feel right now. That's what I'm saying, if he was right. So he would be ever, give me a kiss, Ray. Bury yourself alive. Go, here's a spoon. Dig something and bury yourself. Go. Oh my God. You're telling all these girls who don't like you. It's not even like they even fucking like you or like me. They don't even like you and you don't even like them. And you telling them our family business, girl, gonna sit down on it. Hell no, I don't love her no more. Okay? Snap out of it. You can't just fuck with a beehive and then when the bees come out and attack, why are they attacking me? Oh my God, there's so many of them. Why are they attacking me? Oh, go. Right. You can't just say this about Ray. Why isn't he loving me? Why isn't he kissing me? Yeah, you want your ass to go on a trip. Go on. Close the door. You was like, you're not going to give me a kiss? Close the door, bitch. I wasn't fucking with you before the cameras were rolling, and you know I'm not gonna fuck with you while they are. Get in the car before I embarrass you. I'm gonna close your fucking ankle up in this door trying to get your ass off. I'm gonna close your ankle in this door. Put your foot in the door, Karen, and drive off with these fake bitches. Go. That's what Ray said that one time when they went on a trip. He talked to them the way they need to be talked to. Mm-hmm. And poor Ashley. She doesn't trust her husband, and she shouldn't. And, oh, let's talk about these outfits during the little sex party, honey. What was the dominatrix party? Candace looked the best. But it's not hard to do when you ain't no bigger than a keychain, honey. You can get a washcloth and turn it. Ooh, what's that? Ooh, it's a washcloth, child. She a size zero. She can do it. So disappointed at the Giselle again, honey. She had on them. Now, it would have worked. First of all, she was giving me vanity. 1983. I told you she's stuck in the 80s. She been had that damn bustier. She did not buy that bustier new because nobody sells it like that. But she had on a red bustier, which was beautiful. And like I said, she's a classic beauty. It was good on her skin tone. And I love her eyes and everything. She was beautiful. But then she had these shorts on. But below the shorts was this long black line on her thigh. I said, you didn't see that when you walked out the room? Let's just have a moment of silence for fashion. Because they fucking killed it. Fashion is dead. It's dead. Gone. No more Anna Wintour. Go. Fashion is gone. No. I just couldn't believe she had that line. It was a big circle around her leg under the pant. I can't. And I don't even think I'm going to do any more reviews because I don't want to be mean. I don't. So I'm going to have to, you know, not put myself in a situation where I will go fucking ballistic. Let me see it again. You should have had on some of them stockings like Wendy had on. Or some fishnet. Come prepared. This is a TV show. We know Christmas is coming a whole year. Bitch, you knew you was going to be famine and you going out the country. Get your outfits ready 4 and 5 months before. Stop playing with me. Stop playing with me. Snap out of it. You didn't see Dominique Devereaux and Alexis Carrington fucking with you? This is a TV show like that, Pumpkin Lamb. You're the new dynasty. It's dynasty on crack, honey. Give us these outfits and comb your damn hair, Robin. And quit putting a cup of water on your hair every time you leave a house. Turn water upside down. Okay, y'all ready? Where are my keys? You not gonna dry that shit off your head? No, she's not. She never has. Just give her the keys to the truck, honey. She's an 18-wheeler truck driver. It's so sad. Y'all have this platform. And then Giselle keeps talking about Karen. Every night she got a new business. She got a, cause she's like Candy. You should be doing it instead of talking about her, Sheree. Talking about everybody ain't doing shit. Every time she got a wig shop. Right, that's what you do when you're on a platform like this. That's what you do. You got free marketing right now. What are you selling? And I almost backed out when she said she gave oral sex 2 weeks ago. Because you know her and the pastor aren't married. So everybody in the congregation gonna know that she gave him fellatio 2 weeks ago when they in the parking lot on Sundays. They turn their radio on and then he be preaching outside in the parking lot. And everybody gonna know, ooh, he got some 2 weeks ago. We don't need to know this. About pastor. It's a no for me. I mean, I know I do what I do, but I'm not a pastor. I'm not a first lady, honey. You know what I'm saying? Because if I were, I would just, I know. I've been in a situation where I was kind of like that, but it was for a different genre. But you carry yourself accordingly. You carry yourself accordingly. You don't go to the Jack and Jill meeting, chewing gum and patting your head, talking about, I'm a Jack and Jill too. Like, there's a time and place for everything. I just don't think that Giselle should have said, I gave him fellatio 2 weeks ago. Because now you're teaching your daughters. And you're telling the church and you're telling his business. It's not just your business. It's his business too. And you're doing all this for this talk show. Honey, if you want some attention, start dressing. Because you got the foundation. You got everything. Now you need a stylist. You need a gay friend with sugar dripping out his ass, honey. When he gets out his seat, I want to see a pile of sugar in his seat. You need a gay friend like that that's going to be like, girl, these are the lashes you use. This is the foundation. This is this. This is that. And I mean, he better have been, grew up in the house of something. The house of Chanel or the house of so-and-so, one of the ball. You know what I'm saying? That be beating the girls. That's who you need. That's who you need. And you need him quick, honey. The house is on fire, bitch. Get the cat out. It's like that crucial. And then that way you don't have to be saying things like, I gave him fellatio 2 weeks ago. You should have really thought about that before you said that. You should have thought about that. I would just clutch my imaginary gay pearls. I was, ooh. All right, guys. Well, thank you so much for hanging out. Alexa, play last song. Thank you so much for hanging out with me. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like the video, comment. I would like, definitely like for you to comment. Who is this? Oh, we got a jam. Oh, I think that's Club Nouveau. You remember Club Nouveau? But, oh, hold on, let's do this. Alexa, play Alexander O'Neal and Sherelle's Saturday Love.
Here's Saturday Love. 12
and this is how we're going to end it. Oh, not a whole 12 inches.
On Amazon Music.
Say 12 inches of version.
Never on Sunday. Monday's too soon. Tuesday and Wednesday just won't do.
Thursday and Friday, we can begin. But our Saturday love will never end. Hey! I'll see you guys next time on the Mario Ramon Review. Thank you so much for hanging out with me. Happy Sunday and have a great evening. Peace.